Good evening, my brothers and sisters. I hope that this day, this evening, this afternoon, find you doing well. And this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I hope that you all have had a good day. God is still in control. No matter what has happened, God is still in control. And we, even in the midst of all of this chaos and things happening, and we're losing folks right and left. We heard of the passing of Minister Nettie Smith, and we in prayer with and for the family. And God is still going to bring us through this. God is going to bring us through this. I have all confidence in the world that in His timing, He will bring us through this. But we have to stay faithful, and we have to keep praying that God is going to make a way out of no way. And it is all going to work together for our good. Amen. And we are looking forward to the day that we can come back together and fellowship one with another. There is a word for this afternoon. And before we go into our word, we ask to join us in a word of prayer. Dear Father, we come in the name of Jesus. Father, we come thanking you for things being as well as they are. I thank you for being our God, our Father. Lord, you brought us through so much, and you're going to bring us through this. I have all confidence, all faith in the world. Father, I ask that you be with the people who are sick, be with those who are in bereavement, who've lost loved ones. Father, we pray for them. We ask that you allow your Holy Spirit to provide comfort and consolation in their time of need, in their time of despair. Be with them, Father. And Father, I ask that you continue to strengthen the church as a whole and as a body to stay faithful and to continue to hold on to your unchanging hand. Father, we believe you. Bless this word today. We believe you that is done. Bless this word today, Father. Let our people be doers of the word and not just hearers only. These and other blessings we ask in our son Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Today's word comes from the gospel according to St. Mark and that fourth chapter. I'll try not to be with you too long today. The gospel according to St. Mark and that fourth chapter and that 40th verse. And I want to read two versions. I want to read the King James Version, and then I want to read the English Revised Version. And that verse says, "And he said unto them, Why are ye so fearful? How is it that ye have no faith?" That's the King James Version. And the English Revised Version says, "Why are you afraid? Do you still have no faith?" We'd like to speak to you from a thought today, having faith in the storm. Having faith in the storm. Because it's easy to be faithful when nothing is going on, but can you have faith when the storm comes? A little background on what was going on. Jesus had spent a full day of teaching, and they were going to retire for the evening or for the day. And he and his disciples got into a boat to go across the Sea of Galilee. And all of a sudden a storm rose up and water started filling the boat. But Jesus had, when he got on the boat, he went in the, as the Bible says, the hinder part of the ship, and he laid down on a pillow and went to sleep. And while all of this storm was going on, Jesus was lying down on his pillow asleep. His disciples were afraid of the storm, and they start throwing things over to make the boat lighter, and they start trying to get water out of the boat. And then when they saw that nothing was wrong, nothing was helping, they got scared. They thought that they were going to die, and they went to wake Jesus up. And when they went to wake him up, they said, "Master, carest thou not that we perish?" In other words, they said, "We're about to die in this storm, and you acting like you don't care that we are." This is what they told Jesus. Then Jesus got up, rebuked the storm. He spoke firmly and rebuked the wind and the sea. And he said, "Peace, be still." And when he said, "Peace, be still," the wind acted like it was listening to him, and the wind stopped blowing. The sea understood that the master of the sea had spoken, and it became calm. He turned to his disciples, and then Jesus says, as our verse says today, "Why are you so fearful? What are you afraid of? How is it that you have no faith?" Or as the ERV says, "Why are you afraid? Do you still have no faith? I've been with you this long. You've seen what I can do. You know what I can do. Why are you still acting like you're scared and I'm right here with you?" My brothers and sisters, don't get mad with the disciples. Don't get mad with the disciples. Some of y'all are saying that they should have known better. Jesus was right there. Jesus did all the miracles right there. They should have known better and not been afraid. But no, my brothers and sisters, they were only being human, and they were overwhelmed with fear and doubt, just like we do sometimes. So my question to you today is, when the storms of life begin to rage in your life, when they're on their way in our lives, how do you react? Do you remain calm, cool, and collected, knowing that everything is going to be all right? Or do you act like the disciples? Sometimes you have your moments of being fearful and doubtful because it looks hopeless. And if truth be told, and if you're honest with yourself, if we're honest with ourselves, all of us have those moments when we may feel that it is what it is and it ain't gonna get no better. I know that's incorrect grammar, but y'all understand what I'm saying. See, and this is how the disciples felt when the storm came all up all of a sudden. And we all have storms that come up all of a sudden. Everything can be going good. It can be sunny outside. And then all of a sudden a storm comes. And that storm comes and it catches us off guard. And when it catches us off guard, it can be scary and it can be threatening. And it's certainly understandable that that one would respond to the storm the way that the disciples did. They were scared. All of a sudden, they thought that they were going to lose their lives. All of a sudden, the storm comes and it catches them off guard. And even with Jesus on board, they couldn't think straight because of the storm. So why didn't Jesus react like the disciples? They were going crazy. They were about to lose their mind. They were scared that they were going to die. But yet Jesus didn't act like they were acting. While all of this was going on, he remained asleep on the pillow in the lower part of the boat. With all the wind blowing, with all the water beating up against the ship and coming into the ship, and the disciples screaming out of fear and doubt, he remained asleep. Jesus didn't react as they did because he didn't see the situation in the same way that they viewed it. All of them were panicked and they were distraught, but Jesus was sleeping. They were upset and they were screaming, but Jesus was sleeping. They thought that they were going to lose everything, including their lives. But Jesus was sleeping. And then when they woke him up, he still didn't act like there was some sense of urgency needed. He didn't act like he had to get in a hurry, but he looked around and he's still being calm, and he spoke to the wind and to the storm. And he said, "Now y'all need to calm down." He said, "Peace, be still." Now, the questions that he asked the disciples were not about the call, what caused the storm, but the question that he asked them were about why y'all acting like y'all acting in the storm. So it had nothing to do with the storm coming and the causes of the storm. His questions were, why are you reacting the way that you're reacting to this storm? In other words, Jesus was saying the storm don't matter, but your reactions do. Because storms are a part of life. David said that many are the afflictions of the righteous. Then he said, but the Lord will deliver them out of them all. Now, the question Jesus had for them, why y'all acting like y'all acting? Storms gonna come, but I'm on board this ship. Storms are going to rise in our lives, but as the disciples of Jesus, we should be, what should our reactions be to those storms? They're going to come, but what should our reactions be to those storms? Well, according to the example that Jesus was setting for his disciples, they should not have been afraid. Let me say that again. According to the example that Jesus set for his disciples, or what Jesus was setting for his disciples, they should not have been afraid. They should have had more faith. Don't you know who's on board the ship? I know the storms are all around, but don't you know who's on board the ship? I know the water looks like it's coming in and we might sink, but don't you know who's on board the ship? If it looks like it's gonna overwhelm us, but don't you know who's on board your ship? They should have had more faith. They saw the miracles. They saw what Jesus could do. They heard his teaching. They heard Jesus talk. They should have had more faith because he was on board the ship. They should have risen above the situation with their faith because Jesus was on board. They should have recognized who was on board with them, and they should not have been afraid. But because they weren't at the level they should have been at, because they did not have the strength of the Holy Spirit to hold them, they had Jesus there with them, they were afraid. They were afraid. So why didn't Jesus act like they acted? Because Jesus had faith. When Jesus said to them in verse 35, let us pass over to the other side. Notice this. Let me say this again. When Jesus said to them in verse 35 of that same chapter, he said, let us pass over to the other side. He was letting them know that nothing was going to stop them from getting to the other side. Why? Because he said so. Y'all missed that. Jesus said, let us pass over to the other side. Yes, yes, yes. He said, let us pass over to the other side. He was letting them know that nothing was going to stop them from getting to the other side. Somehow, some way, we are going to get to the other side. Why? Because he said so. You can always count on Jesus's word. If Jesus said it, that settles it. When he said it, that settled it right there. And no demon, no storm, no trial, no trouble, no trial, no tribulation, nothing is going to stop his word. Nothing will ever be able to stop his word. If he said it, it will come to pass. This is what Jesus said. He said it, and it will come to pass. Jesus was able to sleep during the storm because he had faith in whom he was and who was with him. Yes, yeah. He had faith of who he was. He knew that he was a child of the Almighty. He knew that he was the Almighty. He knew that God was with him. And we too have to realize who we are and who is with us. We got to realize who we belong to. And like Paul said in Romans 8, if God be for us, who can be against us? And my faith must tell me that as long as Jesus is in my ship, as long as Jesus is on board with me, as long as Jesus is on the inside of me, no storm, no demon, no trial, no trouble, and nobody should be able to shake my faith that Jesus won't see me through. Oh, greater is he who is within me than he that's in the world. I got to know and know without a shadow of a doubt that as long as Jesus is with me, then nothing is impossible. As long as Jesus was with me, somehow we're going to make it through. So we got to have Jesus with us. We got to have faith in the midst of our storm. No matter how bad it looked, no matter how painful it might be, we still have to have faith in the midst of our storm. We got to have faith in the storm. We got to know who's riding with us. Jesus is on board our ship. Jesus is in the ship. Jesus is in the house. We got to have faith in the storm. And I know somehow he's going to make a way. Won't he do it? I gotta know how. I gotta know that somehow, some way he is going to work. I don't know when, I don't know how, I just know he's going to do it. That's what it means to have faith in the storm. And because we get rattled sometime, that lets us know that we still have some growing to do in the faith arena. We're not all that in a bag of chips, because sometimes we still doubt. Sometimes we still have a little worry here or there. So we have to pray as the lunatic's father had prayed to Jesus. And he said, Lord, heal my unbelief. So our prayer should be today, Lord, heal our unbelief. Lord, in certain things, we are strong, we are faithful. And then a storm comes all of a sudden and it shakes our foundation and it rocks our foundation. Lord, we need for you to heal our unbelief. Even though you might be asleep and we can't feel you, we can't hear from you, we just got to know in faith that you're still in the ship. And as long as you in the ship, we know that everything is going to be all right. So we have a choice this afternoon. We have a choice of trusting Jesus in our storms or letting the storm get the victory. We have those choices. Trusting Jesus in our storm or letting the storm get the victory. But I came to give you some good news this evening. Jesus is in the ship with you. And as long as Jesus is in the ship with you, you can rise above your storms with your faith. You just got to believe. You can rise above your storms with your faith. And just know that we can do all things. Paul said it best when he said, I can do all things. I'm going to say we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. We just have to know that we have to have faith in the storm. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. I hope someone was encouraged, because some of us are going through storms right now. Some of us feel that there is no hope. All hope is gone. But I stopped by to tell you this afternoon that Jesus is on board your ship. He is in the ship. All you have to do is cry out to him and say, Lord, have mercy. Lord, help us. And Jesus will rise up in the midst of that storm and speak to whatever is going on. He's not looking at the storm. Storms are going to come. He's looking at where you are in your faith. And if I know that Jesus got it under control and it's all in his hand, everything is going to be all right. So I'm telling you this afternoon, just calm down. Let Jesus speak to your storm and let him work it out. God bless you. I love all of you. And thank you all so much for joining us and being with us. And I thank God for all of you who support this ministry. And we pray that you continue. We will be there at the house on Saturday. Our trustee committee will be there on Saturday morning, December the 12th. And that's this Saturday at 10 o'clock. And this will be the only time in December that we will be there. So whatever you're planning to do for December, go ahead and do it on that day, or you'll have to wait until January. But whatever you're doing, whatever you're going to do, go ahead and do it on Saturday. And if you're mailing your tithe, your contributions in, that address is Mizpah Baptist Church, Post Office Box 1275, Baxley, Georgia 31515, Post Office Box 1275. Baxley, Georgia, 31515. All right, it's time for me to get out of here. But God bless you. And mask up. You got to be safe. People are testing positive right and left with this stuff. But you got to take precautions with yourself. If you don't have to be in crowd, don't get out there in crowd. Always when you go out and you leave your house, stay masked up. Remember about this election that's coming up. Early voting going to start next Monday, the 14th. So get out and vote, or get your mail-in ballot and send it in. Make sure that you've signed everything you need to sign and sealed it up in those two envelopes. Make sure that you've done that. And let's go ahead and do what we need to do. All right, we're done for today. I love all of you. So you take care of yourselves and each other. Continue to pray for me as I pray for all of you. And until we are able to meet again, until next time, God bless you.